Hi, and welcome to another episode of Detail TV. In today's episode, we'll teach you how to remove very deep scratches from paintwork. When we say very deep scratches, we mean the kind that are just shy of being too deep to remove, but not so deep that they've gone through the clear coat layer. Detailers can only completely remove marks within the clear coat layer. Here's our head detailer, Damian, to explain why.
Hey guys, professional detailers refer to paint as film build. Film build consists of all the layers above the substrate, which in most cases is sheet metal. Film build removal is fastest when wet sanding processes are used, and as such we only recommend using sandpaper on good condition paintwork with ample clear coat thickness. If you're unsure of your clear coat thickness, you'll need a thickness gauge to measure clear coat, or simply don't carry out any wet sanding processes. For more info on film build and the use and types of paint thickness gauges, visit this article in the Final Inspection blog.
When you have marks in paintwork that are stubborn and you're finding that regular polishing, even with super aggressive polishes, aren't removing the marks or aren't removing them easily, you need another form of attack, and it isn't more aggressive polishes that leave nasty trace marks. It's sanding. Using sandpaper to re-level paintwork is super aggressive, and it should be the last resort because it rapidly removes paint. However, polishing the same section over and over again can actually remove more paint than using a single and efficient sanding process before polishing. For instance, from our tests, using 6 passes of cap heavy on a white SHD pad will result in more paint removal as one effective pass of 3000 grit sandpaper, which is about 1/2 of a micron. When you repeat a pass, you usually carry out each pass immediately after each other, which can result in extreme heat build. Or, if you're cooling down the panel as you should be between each pass, incredible inefficiency. The more efficient, safer method with the least amount of paint removal is to wet sand. Once to remove the imperfection and polish, and once to remove the wet sanding marring. The benefits of this process are as follows. The wet sanding results in no heat buildup. Efficiency gains are made as you require less time to remove the imperfections. And there are material cost savings as you use significantly less polish and have less pad wear. You'll also benefit from less machine wear and tear. We're going to remove these imperfections using the following tools. First, a final inspection denibbing block and a 3000 grit single-use sanding pads. Now onto correction of the sanded area. Apply a small amount of polish to your polishing pad and begin to polish the sanded area with a low speed, constantly moving the machine, which avoids generating too much heat. Here we're using cap heavy with a 90mm heavy cutting pad. When the wet sanded marks have been removed, we'll gloss the surface by carrying out a second stage. Here we're using cap ultra fine on a polishing pad. Total cost for a pad converter, a 90mm pad, a 275mm bottle of cap heavy, and a denibbing block, and 10 3000 grit pads is $50. So this professional process is very inexpensive. Try it at home by following the tutorial as we've described. I hope this has been helpful. I'm Erika from Final Inspection. I'll see you next time.